Bears on the Run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States, well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
I began to get into iodine a few years ago because it was helping me and my family so much get healthy and detoxify. Most people know that iodine deficiency has been a crisis around the world. Iodine is key to so many of the body's functions, especially the thyroid. I discovered a product being developed by Dr. Group. You now know it as Survival Shield, true nascent iodine that your body can really absorb. Then, about a year ago, he said, listen, if you think this is powerful, I'm going to come out with rare earth, deep earth crystals. And the results that I personally have had have been life-changing. Nobody else has got iodine based on these pure crystals, ladies and gentlemen. This is innovating, and the best part is it helps fund InfoWars.com, the radio show, the TV show, the whole media operation promoting true libertarian ideas.
For a limited time, experience the ancient power of Survival Shield X2. Take advantage of this unprecedented 30% off super detox special at InfoWarsLife.com.
General, what do you think about the FBI saying that there's a terror alert on Monday about a potential Fort Hood situation?
The police are shoving people, shoving Alex, shoving the crowd.
Here we go, folks, I'm being assaulted.
Whether it's the radio show, the news websites, documentary films, or the nightly news, InfoWars is the tip of the spear.
Is this another false flag stage attack to take our civil liberties and put more homeland security while sticking our hands down on pants on the streets?
It's up to us to set brush fires in the minds of men and women everywhere. And that's what PrisonPlanet.tv is designed to do.
You watch, the Assad regime is going to be blamed or accused of using chemical weapons against the so-called rebels.
What we see now is a war against reality. It's a war against the truth.
It's more vital than ever that supporters of freedom become members of PrisonPlanet.tv and share their membership with up to 11 friends and family. Visit InfoWarsNews.com today. Become a member, share your membership, and help take the info war to the next level.
Take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance. You're listening to Alex Jones.
All right, my friends. Let's go to your phone calls. I want to be clear, though. The reason you see so much corruption intensifying worldwide is a lot of reasons. But Hollywood's corruption, populations battling for scarce resources, that's part of the natural ebb and flow of society. It's just now we have nuclear weapons, biological weapons, drones, you name it. But the political elites are so removed from the battlefield, so removed from what they're politically doing, that that's a big part of why we see things getting so dangerous. I think about the neocon women that run the State Department, Samantha Powers and others. When they give speeches or briefings, if I saw someone at a restaurant who looked and acted like them, I would say that's a very dangerous mentally ill person. Hillary Clinton, if she was just a normal person with her statements and the way she acts and looks, I would say that's a neurotic, bad person on a power trip. Look out. And I always hear, oh, if women ran things, there'd be no war in the world. What a load of bull. I'm not attacking women right now. It's just that the whole gimmick of Hillary Clinton, I have been looking at her since 1992. 22 years since high school. When that whole presidential election was going on, I'm 40. I'm sick of her. And I'm going to have to hear the gimmick of, oh, you're not for Hillary. You don't like women and women's groups for their signs. I'm for Hillary. Time for a woman to be in charge. She's been in charge. And if the Republican leadership has their way, they're going to have some socialist, crumb bum, neocon, fake rhino run against her and hand it to her. And if this country doesn't get upset, and I don't mean the whole country, but the large minority of people who are every race, color, and creed, who know what's going on, if we don't get upset and just start saying no, then stick a fork in us, we're done. Because it's just getting worse and worse and worse and crazier and weirder and stupider. They teach kids 2 + 2 = 5. When I first learned about that in Common Core like 3 or 4 years ago, I went, that's not true. That's a headline. And I went and looked it up, and they had real curriculum saying 2 + 2 isn't always 4. It could be 3 or 5. It's all how you feel. And then Obama said, I didn't build my operation. And then increasing a debt doesn't increase a debt. I mean, it makes me so angry. The New York Times came out over the weekend. Kurt Nemo wrote an article about it, endorsing the death panels. And there were people commenting on my website going, well, there are, you know, there's not enough money, blah, blah, blah. If you didn't have government involved and it was free market and charities, the care would be competitive and super cheap. We had the best and cheapest healthcare in the world in 1950. Look up the numbers. Now we've got some of the most expensive screwed up healthcare. That's because government got involved, regulators got involved, and they screwed this country up. And I'm tired of sitting here in the country I love watching it go to hell in a handbasket while a bunch of foreign, offshore, globalist. I went into a jewelry store to get my daughters some little, you know, $50, $60 Tiffany silver necklaces. So I've never got them anything like that. And I bought them Tiffany rattles when they were babies, which they don't even make anymore. You know, those were like $100 or something. And so I went in, and I was in this place, and there was a picture of Warren Buffett. And I said, what's Warren Buffett have to do with this? They go, oh, Warren Buffett bought this family-owned jewelry chain. And I went in there because I knew it was a family-owned jewelry chain out of Seattle. And I still got the stuff and then left. But I knew they carried some of that Tiffany stuff. I was just going, it doesn't even matter. The point is, it's just like, one of my buddies lives in a building downtown, and I looked at who owned it. Always looks it's Warren Buffett. And then I was just thinking about how he's got all these banker bailouts, all these insider deals, and then he lobbies to raise taxes on poor people. Makes me want to throw up. I don't want to just get off on some Warren Buffett jag. But I was in a jewelry store and had to look at him. All because I wanted to give my daughter some jewelry and teach him how to take care of stuff. So they can wear it to church or whatever. And I've got all these calls, all this important news. It's just, I am fundamentally being robbed and screwed over by people like Warren Buffett and Bill Gates. I know what they've committed against me. I know who they are. I know how they're funding the whole gun control agenda, along with George Soros. I don't like them. Because they've dominated me. They're screwing over my country I love. Why don't you take it personal? I mean, I see guys. I was at the grocery store, and I was in line, and these two guys were arguing with each other about who was going to win some Labor Day football game. They were getting aggressive with each other and showing off. And, oh, yeah, well, they've got a deeper, you know, weapons arsenal, blah, 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 on the side. And, oh, yeah, well, they've got such, oh, yeah. And it's like men are supposed to be like that about
you know, over this hill is where the line of the such and such tribe is, and if you cross that, they will attack you for hunting in that area. But I believe that we should be able there because my grandfather hunted in that area. You know, that's a 10,000-year-old worldview. Or 1,000 years ago about, you know, we need to get together and form a military alliance with this tribe because we're going to be hit by the and sacked by these vandals that, you know, hit us 20 years ago again. And they've been raiding up and down the coast. I mean, men are supposed to be knowing how things work, involved, serious, honorable, warriors at the same time. And I just look at men and they're just laying out, acting cool. And they're so unmanly. Even if they're all roided out and acting tough with a shaved head, a man knows about geopolitical issues. A man knows about finances. A man knows how the world works. A man is involved. And it's because we are a dishonored society that isn't led by good men. We are led by the worst men and worst women out there imaginable. And we have accepted lie, after fraud, until we don't even know who we are anymore. Let me tell you, it's a big deal to have that southern border open. And to just be flooded with people, with U-Hauls and trucks and just buses just full. I mean, I'll pull into a Target or something, and it's just, there'll be like three buses with just people pouring out with their bags, obvious refugees, like, whoa, what is going on? As the country collapses, as we go into depression, what is the government planning? And then I don't disagree with Roberts completely. I'm the guy that used to debate with him 10 years ago about whether 9/11 was an inside job or not. He came around to the fact that it is. That's a guy that's in the, you know, all these big, huge think tanks, Brookings, you name it. I mean, he's high level, folks. So when I get up here and I say, no, ISIS is real, ISIS is the most radical, dangerous people there are. They're allowed to go back and forth to England, back and forth to France. They're being left. They're allowed to operate on Twitter and Facebook. It's in the news again today, whereas they're always censoring my stuff. And I happen to know that this terror threat is real from our military and Border Patrol sources. I can't say anymore. I don't want to get subpoenaed or get arrested, okay? Because this is national security stuff. I'm just going to leave it at that. That they're being told, shut up, this stuff's being leaked. Do you think Obama wants people to know there's ISIS down the border? No, they want him to let him hit us, and then he'll just play dumb. And the media won't call him, he'll get away with it and take basic freedoms of Americans. No. The Al-Qaeda people are working with the drug cartels because it's very similar criminal culture operations. Strongmen operations, whole nine yards. There's a lot of Saudi Arabian money. There is an Islamicist move, a radical Islamicist move worldwide right now. All right, I'm going to shut up and go to your calls. Blake and Curtis and Danny and John in the UK and John in Florida. I'm going to get to all of you. I'm going to shut up. Blake, I held you over because Roberts came on. You were talking about doing deliveries to hotels all over Oklahoma and how they're just full of illegals waiting to try to find a house or whatever. Government and charities are putting them up in the hotels. You can go further and get that from the hotel staff. We've confirmed it. We were told by ICE and Border Patrol, come down here to McAllen. You will see us being forced to load them on buses and pay for their tickets and give them food. Remember, they want... See, Obama comes out and says, sorry, I can't do anything for you on immigration today. See the shill there? He's totally basically ended deportations 97%. They're letting felons go. They're busing the people in. But meanwhile, that's not enough. They've got illegals protesting the White House every day. Every day. They're allowed to. I'm not. I've been there. You've seen the video. The Secret Service says no cameras, no protesting. We'll arrest you. The illegals can march around all day, and they're all angry. How dare you only give me welfare and free rides everywhere? This is not enough. I want everything now. Just marching around everywhere. And going, Obama, you see that cover? It's a full spectrum of lies. They create a whole paradigm of fraud where you're just swimming in an ocean of lies. And so Obama had not enough for Latinos, as if that's what you, as if you are Hispanic in any way, you're supposed to just want totally open borders when no one else does that in the world.
And when it's collapsing countries, the depression is global, folks. The depression is here. It's worse in Latin America. And the message is being sent, come here. So the